Graphic Audio. A movie in your mind.
Graphic Audio presents Stage to Death by Wayne D. Overholser. It had rained hard for 2 days, hard enough to turn the Suntex County roads into greasy gumbo and bring the creeks and rivers boiling over their banks. It had stopped now, but the May sky was still as gray as a goose wing and bore promise of another downpour. Bill Mason, stage guard on the Opal City to Tamarack run, stood against the bar in the Last Chance Saloon and stared thoughtfully through the fly-specked window at the leaden sky. In a few minutes, the stage would pull out for Tamarack. Maybe it would get through, and maybe it wouldn't, for it had to cross the Sundown and Paiute Rivers, and both were mud-yellow, roaring torrents.
Hello, Billy Bach.
Icy fingers knotted Bill's stomach muscles. He hadn't been called Billy Bach since he'd been a wild young hellion back in the Colorado mining camps. Here in Oregon, nobody knew who he was. Nobody knew what he'd been. Nobody knew about the bank job in Silver Creek, where he'd had his first and last taste of the owl hoot and found it not to his liking. He was Bill Mason, stage guard, with a 3-year perfect record to his credit. Slowly, Bill's eyes turned to the man who had come up behind him. He was a stranger, clad in a yellow slicker, a leggy man almost as tall as Bill, with a saber-like nose and a pair of eyes as hard and sharp as chipped obsidian. A tough hand, Bill saw, with the stamp of the owl hoot upon him.
You got me wrong, feller. My handle's Mason, Bill Mason.
Sure, I know. You're Bill Mason now, all right. It wouldn't do to be Billy Bach out here. Some folks wouldn't like it if they found out the gent they looked up to on account of his guts and fast guns had committed a robbery back in Silver Creek, Colorado.
You seem to know quite a bit, feller.
Yeah, quite a bit. I ain't got nothing against you, Billy Bach. Neither's the Domino Kid.
I don't know the Domino Kid. What's he got to do with it?
Plenty. You'd know the kid all right if you seen him without his mask, but we'll let that go. What I'm getting at is whether you're gonna be smart so we can make a deal, or if you're gonna be fool enough to make me tell them certain folks about the Silver Creek job.
What's the deal?
In a few minutes, you'll be heading out with Mac Travers. Your box is gonna be heavy enough to make a good picking for the kid. Now, the kid don't want no trouble. Of course, if there is trouble, I reckon he can handle it. And the way the weather is, he could get clear before the sheriff caught his trail. Still and all, the kid don't like shooting. If you just hand the box down and forget your guns, I'll ride on, and nobody's gonna know about Silver Creek.
Maybe them certain folks wouldn't believe your yarn.
And again, they might. Travers is no friend of yours. Neither is Eli Crone and Tamarack. Even Sam Benton might do a little quizzing around if he knew what I know.
All that was true enough. Both Travers and Crone, the Tamarack agent, were new men, and they'd plainly showed their dislike for Bill. Why, he didn't know, but he did know he valued Sam Benton's friendship and trust. Benton was the supervisor, and he'd given Bill his job. Then there was Laura Benton, Sam's girl. 6 months ago, she'd returned to Opal City from Portland, where she'd been going to school. From the moment Bill had seen her standing beside Sam's desk, he'd known exactly what the future would be for him without Laura. Balancing that knowledge had been the bitter realization that a man with his past could never tell her how he felt.
Well, what's it gonna be?
How'd you know so much about the setup here?
That's none of your business. I'm asking one question, and I want the answer.
The answer is that you can go to hell.
I ain't surprised. It's sure funny how righteous a gent gets when he thinks he's got a good thing. You're a fool, Billy Bach. You rode with Stony Crass once. That put a brand on you you'll always wear. After you think about it a spell, maybe you'll get over me.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.